something changed in your life, but you had the exact same amount of money, or you paid off a bunch of debt, but then you had the exact same amount of debt. It's what you were a match for. It's what you expected. So even when your outside experience didn't change, your energy didn't change, so you had the same thing again. I believed I would have just enough, and that is what I had. And then this crazy thing happened. My goal had been $3,000 a month, once my business was supporting me. I was nannying part-time, I was working my business part-time, I needed $3,000 a month. So my goal had been $3,000. And then I had started to up it, and I wanted it to be $4,500 a month was where I was going, because that was more than $50,000 a year, and that's what I wanted all the time. So by January was $3,000, by May I was doing $4,500. So it was funny, I hit my first $4,500 in May of whatever that year it was, 2012 or 2014. So I hit my $4,500. I know what it was, I was also in a PhD program. So I was coaching, that was giving me money, I was nannying, that was giving me money, and I had a stipend from my PhD program, right? And I remember I hit my $4,500 a month like in May. And then I quit the PhD program, so my stipend wasn't gonna be there anymore, my $1,500 wasn't gonna be there anymore, right? And then June came and I still had $4,500, and July came and I still had $4,500. It became obvious to me in that moment that if that $1,500 could go away and I could make the exact same amount of money the next 2 months, that it was about a whole lot more than just how the money was coming in. It became clear to me that I was a vibrational match for that amount of money, if an income stream could be taken away and I could make the exact same amount. My new minimum had become $4,500, so even if $1,500 was taken away, there was no way I was available for less than $4,500, and it found its way to me in other ways. I got new clients. Clients paid ahead of time. Is this making sense? Does this resonate with any of you? Something changed in your life, but you had the exact same amount of money, or you paid off a bunch of debt, but then you had the exact same amount of debt. It's what you were a match for. It's what you expected. So even when your outside experience didn't change, your energy didn't change, so you had the same thing again. Does that make sense? And in that moment, when I realized that I had made I'd made the exact same amount again, even though something in my external world changed, I was like, this is about energy. And it was like a pivotal aha moment for me. And I had, let me tell you this, I don't know if this will resonate with any of you either, but I remember in grad school, I had like four different apartments. I had a different apartment each year, and the rent was different each year. And it was like I would get a nicer apartment each time, and I would pay more in rent, but I wasn't making more money, but it didn't affect how much money I had or the debt I had. It was like I showed up to however much money was just enough for me at that time. Does that make sense? It was just an idea that I should never spend more than this or on an apartment. It was just an idea that this, whatever this amount is now the amount I need for my just enough. So you are dictating your just enough, and you can change what your just enough is, and you can decide that your new just enough is a much bigger number. You can turn your just enough into a more than enough, and you can do that for yourself right now. You decide what you're available for. You decide what you're available for. You decide what you need to have the kind of life you want. You decide what you need to spend on. And here's the thing we were talking about in the 2017 Money Mentality Makeover group the other day. It was super good. Someone said, I need a new laptop. She's like, I need a new laptop, but I don't need it. She put quotations around need. She's like, I need a new laptop, but I don't need it. Isn't it wrong for me to just buy this thing and then justify it by saying I need it when I just want it? And I was like, the problem here isn't the laptop or whether you need it or want it. The problem is the guilt in your mind and this idea that you're bad for spending, this idea that you're bad for desiring things or needing things. In my life, whatever I desire is what I'm worthy of and is what I need and is what I'm going to find a way to buy. And there's nothing to be guilty about. Like, God isn't mad at you. Nothing, there no energetic forces or cosmic force. Like, no one's mad at you for wanting a new laptop, whether it's a want or a need or whatever. But her language around I need it and I'm just justifying things I don't really need was full of guilt. and there's something wrong with me and I'm fucking up around money, right? And these are all mentalities. These are all unhealed parts of ourselves when it comes to money. And this is what the money course is for, to go change those unhealed parts of ourselves, to tell new stories, to see things differently, to drop the guilt, to drop the shame, to drop the disbelief, to drop whatever it was that you were told in your household around you being bad for needing things or feeling guilty for needing to be spent on or whatever it was that developed the stories. It's real work. It's real deep healing work. I would never tell you that this course is easy. People tell me they do the homework, they journal, they cry as they look through their limiting beliefs and their history and their fear around money. And it is deep work and it is real work. But you come out on the other side not haphazardly, accidentally manifesting sometimes. You can come out on the other side understanding money, understanding how it flows, understanding your relationship with it, understanding how to be attractive to it. I know that sounds crazy, but to me, money, okay, so you've heard me say it before, money is not good or bad. Money is a neutral resource. Money is something that you can choose to use for your good, right? And to me, so money in my life is a resource, but it's a beautiful resource. It's a resource that I value. It's a resource that I treasure. It's a resource that I consider my friend. It's a resource that I don't have very much guilt left around. Yes, I'm a human. I experience guilt and limiting beliefs and emotions that I have to work through when I set new goals. But as a whole, I know for sure that avalanches of money could come upon me, and that doesn't make me a bad person or a wrong person or a greedy person or a selfish person. So I have a lot of room for money. I've cleared space. I've made room, right? And so when those hangups and the guilt and the drama are gone, it gets so much easier to earn and to receive, because money is your birthright. Money is already yours, and you're just clearing all the things in the way of it away from you so it can flow more easily to you.